Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Quote of the day is, adopt the pace of nature, her secret is patience. Today the topic of my presentation is schistosomiasis, and I am presenting it under the supervision of my professor, Dr. Saira. Learning outlines of the presentation are introduction of the disease, problem statement, mode of transmission, clinical features, prevention and treatment, and recent updates. Learning outcomes. At the end of this presentation, participants will be able to describe about the introduction of the disease, epidemiology, clinical features, level of prevention, along with recent advances and MCQs at the end. Case presentation. A person 40 years old, swimmer as a profession, resident of Begum Court, Lahore, married for 12 years, came to OPD of Mayo Hospital with a history of burning micturition. And for a few days back, he is experiencing small amount of blood in his stool also. He gives history of skin lesions that were itchy and resolved on taking some medicine. On asking about the personal history, he told about his recent trip to Egypt about 6 months back, where he taught some students about swimming. And on physical examination, he is having slight pain in the right upper quadrant. Otherwise, examination is unremarkable. Lab results of the patient show hemoglobin level is about 13.9 milligram per deciliter. Coagulation profile is normal. RFT shows 86 milligram per deciliter urea. Serum creatinine is a bit raised, that is 3.4 for this age. LFTs and shows AST and ALT as 28 and 32 respectively. Fast ELISA show microsomal antigens positive. Antibody testing of the urine shows some eggs of schistosomes. Now introduction. Schistosomiasis, also known as bilharzia, is a disease that is caused by parasitic worms. Although the worm that cause schistosomiasis are not found in the United States, people are infected worldwide. In terms of the impact, this disease is second only to malaria as the most devastating parasitic disease. Schistosomiasis is considered one of the neglected tropical diseases. The parasites that cause schistosomiasis live in certain type of fresh water, snail water. You can become infected when your skin becomes in contact with the contaminated fresh water. Most human infections are caused by Schistosomia mansoni, Schistosomia hematobium, or Schistosoma japonicum. The disease is found in tropical countries in Africa, Caribbean, Eastern, South America, Southeast Asia, and Middle East. In 2010, approximately 238 million people were infected with schistosomiasis, 85% of whom live in Africa. An earlier estimate from 2006 had put the fingers at 200 million people infected. As of the latest WHO record, 236.6 million people were infected in 2019. Estimates regarding the numbers of deaths vary. Worldwide global burden of the disease study issued in 2010 estimated about 12,000 direct deaths, while WHO in 2014 estimated more than 200,000 annual death rates that were related to schistosomiasis. The disease is mostly found in Africa, Asia, South America. Around 700 million people in more than 70 countries live in areas where this disease is common. In tropical countries, it is only secondary to malaria. Life cycle of the disease. Infected individuals release schistosoma eggs into water via the fecal material or urine. After larvae hatch from these eggs, the larvae infect a very specific type of freshwater snail. For example, in hematobium species and species intercalectum, it is snails of the genus Bulinus, and in species of the mansoni, it is Bimophilary, and in species of the spanicum, it is Onychomelania. The schistosoma larvae undergo the next phase of the life cycle in these snails, spending their time reproducing and developing. Once this step has been completed, the parasites leave the snail and enters the warm water column. The parasite can live in the water for only 48 hours without a mammalian host. Once a host has been found, the worm enters its blood vessels. For several weeks, the worm remains in the vessel, continuing its development into adult phase. When maturity is reached, mating occurs and eggs are produced. Eggs enter the bladder and intestine and are excreted through urine and feces, and the process then repeats. If eggs do not get excreted, they can become ingrained in the body tissues and cause a variety of problems such as immune reactions and organ damage. This slide shows the life cycle of schistosomias. This shows the first step is eggs pass from the host into the fresh water. Eggs hatch in water and then release miracidia. Now, what is miracidia? Miracidia is the immature form. Miracidials penetrates the snail. Then in the snail, miracidia develop into sporocytes. Sporocytes become carceri, which are released in the water and may penetrate person's skin. Then these carceri penetrates human. During penetration, carceri develop into schistosomules and travel into liver to mature. And there they become paired adult worms. Paired adult worms travel to the veins in the intestine or bladder where they lay eggs. Other host. Schistosomiasis is also concern for cattle husbandry and mice. Pathogenesis. The infectious stage starts when the free-swimming larval form of the schistosomes, that is cerceri, penetrates the human skin using their suckers, proteolytic enzyme, and tail movements. The cerceri transformed into schistosomule by losing its tail and subsequently travel into the heart and lung through venous system until it eventually reaches the liver where it becomes mature into adult form. Signs and symptoms. The clinical manifestations of the chronic infection is mainly caused by immune reactions to the egg entrapment within the tissues, resulting in granuloma formation and chronic inflammation. Acute infection. Manifestation of acute infection from schistosoma includes carcerial dermatitis, that is in all 2 days, and acute schistosomiasis, that is in 2 to 8 weeks. Minutes to days after initial infection, what happens is cercarial dermatitis, that is swimmer's itch. Swimmer's itch is caused by localized allergic reaction at the site of penetration where they penetrate the skin, causing an inflammatory reaction that is characterized by itchy red pimples and blisters. Few weeks to months after infection happens the Katayama's fever, that is also known as acute schistosomiasis. The exact pathology of the disease is still unknown. However, it is hypothesized to be caused by a systemic immune response due to immune complex formation, that is type 3 hypersensitivity reaction. With the foreign antigens on the migratory schistosomules and the eggs and subsequent deposition of these complexes on various tissues leading to activation of an autoimmune response. Now, what is Katayama syndrome or acute schistosomiasis? It is the systematic serum sickness-like illness that develops after several weeks in some, but not most individuals with new schistosomal infection. It may correspond to the first cycle of egg deposition and is associated with marked peripheral eosinophilia and circulating immune complexes. There are two forms of schistosomiasis, acute and chronic. In acute, rash, swimmer's itch, fever, cough, chills, and muscle aches are found. While in chronic, there is abdominal pain, ascites, enlarged liver, splenomegaly, blood in stool, diarrhea, hematuria, dysuria, varicose veins, seizures, and paralysis may happen. And the picture shows the depiction of these both these forms. Clinical features may be generalized lymphadenopathy, may be there. Pleuritic rash, mild fever and headache, hepatosplenomegaly, Katayama syndrome, diarrhea, urticaria, and cough. Now, diagnosis. Diagnosis is first step is in the identification of eggs and stool. Diagnosis of infection is confirmed by identification of eggs and stool. Microscopic identification of eggs and stool or urine is the most practical method for diagnosis. Stool examination should be performed with when infection with species of the men's sony and japonism is suspected and urine examination should be performed in, if hematobium is suspected. Antibody detection. All serum specimens are tested with fast ELISA during schistosomiasis men's sony adult microsomal antigen. A positive reaction greater than 9 units per microliter serum indicates infection with schistosomiasis species. Sensitivity for schistosomiasis men's sony infection is 99%, 95% for the hematobium infection, and less than 50% for japonokim infection. Specificity of the assay for detecting schistosomiasis infection is 99%. Molecular diagnostics. PCR polymerase chain reaction based testing is most accurate and rapid. Laboratory testing. Schistosomiasis hematobium screening in the community can be done by using urine tipped stick to check for hematuria, and stool geriatric test can be used to test for blood and stool. Tissue biopsy from the rectum, bladder, and liver can be obtained to look for the schistosome X within the tissue sample. Imaging modalities may be X-ray, ultrasound, CT, MRI can be utilized to evaluate the severity of schistosomiasis and damages of the infected organs. Prevention and control. The World Health Organization is promoting these efforts to promote the prevention and control of the disease. In some cases, urbanization, pollution, and consequent destruction of snail habitat have reduced exposure with the subsequent decrease in the new infection. The elimination of snail population using mollusides has been attempted to prevent schistosomiasis in the past, but it was an expensive process that affects often only reduces but does not eliminate the snail population. The Center for Disease Control and Prevention advises avoiding drinking or coming into contact with contaminated water in areas where schistosomiasis is common. Now, preventive chemotherapy. The drug praziquantel is used for prevention in high-risk population living in areas where the disease is common. The morbidity control strategy focuses on synchronous chemotherapy for humans and bovine, and the new strategy developed in 2004 intervenes in the transmission pathway for schistosomiasis, mainly including replacement of bovines with machines, prohibition of grazing cattle in the grassland, improving sanitation, installation of fecal matter containers on boats, drug therapy, snail control, and health education. Now, treatment that is specific protection. Two drugs, praziquantel and oxamethasone, are available for the treatment of schistosomiasis. Because of the praziquantel's lower cost per treatment and oxamethasone's lack of efficacy against the urogenital form of the disease that is caused by schistosomiasis hematobium, in general, praziquantel is considered the first option for treatment. It can be safely used in pregnant women and young children. Schistosomiasis is treatable by taking by mouth a single dose of the drug praziquantel annually. Praziquantel only eliminates the adult schistosomes, but it is not effective in killing the eggs and immature worms. Liver eggs can be excreted by infected individuals for weeks after treatment with praziquantel. post-treatment monitoring. Osteopontin is a promising tool for monitoring praziquantel efficacy and post-treatment fibrosis regression, as OPN regression is modulated by schistosomiasis men's sony X antigen, and its level correlates to the severity of schistosomiasis fibrosis and portal hypertension in mice and humans. Now, progress report 2001 to 2011 and strategic plan for 2012 to 2020 that is given by WHO. This map shows the areas where the disease is endemic, has been pandemic, prevalent, or that has never been there in 2010. Now, vision of the strategy is a world free of schistosomiasis. Goals are, first is to control morbidity due to schistosomiasis by 2020, to eliminate schistosomiasis as a public health problem by 2025, to interrupt transmission of schistosomiasis in the region of Americas, the Eastern Mediterranean region, the European region, the Southeast Asia region, and the Western Pacific region, and in selected countries of the African region by 2025. Objectives of the plan are to scale up control and elimination activities in all endemic countries, to ensure an adequate supply of basic rental and resources to meet the demand. The first goal will be achieved when the targets of 100% geographical coverage, 75% national coverage, and less than 5% prevalence of heavy intensity infections are achieved in all schistosomiasis endemic countries. The second goal will be achieved when the prevalence of heavy intensity infection is less than 1% in all endemic countries. The third goal will be achieved when the incidence of schistosomiasis is reduced to zero. Now, recent updates. An article recently published is the global epidemiological situation of schistosomiasis and new approaches to control and research. This shows that the distribution of schistosomiasis has changed over the last 50 years, and there have been a successful control programs. The number of people estimated to be infected or at the risk of infection has not been reduced. Today, 85% of the number of infected people are estimated to be on the African continent, where few control efforts are made. In terms of disease burden, there is therefore a growing discrepancy between sub-Saharan Africa and the rest of the world. WHO has now developed a dual strategy for the control of schistosomiasis, a strategy for morbidity control adopted by public health context in high burden areas, and a strategy to consolidate control in areas where a low endemic level has been reached and elimination may be feasible. Another article published is that prevalence of human schistosomiasis in different areas of Punjab, Pakistan. 2,400 fecal and 300 human blood samples collected from the four districts, Lahore, Sheikhupura, Gujranwala, and Sialkot of the Punjab, and were found negative for the prevalence of schistosomiasis by coprological and serological diagnostic methods. It is the first report showing Punjab, Pakistan is free from human schistosomiasis. Now coming towards the MCQs. First MCQ is, there are many tropical diseases that are not given importance as they require for them to stop. These are the tip of an iceberg and generally known as neglected tropical diseases. Which among the following is considered as neglected tropical disease? Option A, amoebiasis. Option B, giardiasis. Option C, toxoplasmosis. And option D, schistosomiasis.
D.
Yes, option D is the right one, schistosomiasis. Second MCQ is, Mr. Ali got infected from schistosomiasis. Schistosomiasis has snails as its intermediate host, while its eggs reside after hatching from larvae. The larvae of schistosomiasis affect very specific type of snail, and that is, option A, seawater snail, option B, freshwater snail, option C, male type of snails, and option C, female type of snails.
B.
Yes, freshwater snail is the right one. Third MCQ is, the larvae reproduces themselves in snails, and once the step is completed, the parasite's larvae leaves the snail and enters the water column. For how long they can infect a mammalian host that are mostly humans while they're in water? Options are, first is 12 hours, option B is 24 hours, option C 48 hours, and option D 72 hours. Option C is the right one, 48 hours. They can wait for a mammalian host to infect. Fourth MCQ is, acute schistosomiasis is caused in a few weeks and is known as Katayama fever also. The response to antigen is caused by a systematic immune response due to immune complex formation. This comes under the umbrella of which of the following types of allergic reaction? Option is type 1 hypersensitivity reaction, Option is type 2 hypersensitivity reaction. Option C is type 3 hypersensitivity reaction. And option D, type 4 hypersensitivity reaction.
Type 1.
C. Type 3 hypersensitivity reaction, C. Because immune complex formation is being done in this process. And this happens in type 3. Fifth MCQ is, a person is having severe pain abdomen and there is some amount of blood in his urine for past 6 days. He consults his physician. He has some suspicion of schistosomiasis in this patient. Stool examination for the X was advised by him. Stool examination is best for which type of parasitic type? Schistosomiasis mansoni, schistosomiasis hematobium, schistosomiasis bilinus, and option D is onchomelana type.
A.
B. Bhavita.
B.
A.
Yes, option A is the right one. Mansoni is the type for which stool examination is the best. Sixth MCQ is, a person was diagnosed as schistosomiasis through ELISA and eggs were seen in his stool. Schistosomiasis is a treatable disease. Best treatment is by giving praziquantel because of lower cost and easy availability. After initial infection, what amount of drugs should be given to patient to prevent it from further infection? First option is one dose every month. Second is one dose every 3 months. Third is one dose every 6 months. And fourth MCQ option is one dose every year.
B.
B.
Option D is the right one. Annually, one dose is given to prevent the patient from further infection. Seventh MCQ is, WHO has given progress report and strategic plan for the year 2012-22 for the prevention and control of schistosomiasis, and the progress report shows significant improvements in the disease burden and morbidity. To eliminate schistosomiasis as a public health problem by 2025 is which among the following categories? Option A is vision, option B is goal, option D, this is objective, and option D is mission.
B.
B.
Option B is the right one. This is the goal. Eighth MCQ is the Sakari is the part which penetrates the human skin using their suckers. The Sakari travels in the blood after losing their tail and they go to all major viscera of the body. However, which among the following viscera is the place where they become mature in humans? Option A is liver, option B is heart, option C is bladder, and option D is brain.
A, liver.
A.
Yes, liver is the right answer. Ninth MCQ, one stage of schistosomiasis takes about 2 to 8 weeks to develop. The infectious stage of free swimming larval form of schistosome is Sakari. The infectious stage forms after the immediate maturation of which of the following? Option A, mycelial stage. Option B, schistosomule. Option C, sporocytic stage. And option D, egg formation stage.
D.
Option C is the right one, sporocytic stage. First stage is egg formation, then mycelials form, and then sporocytes are formed. Last MCQ is, a person having right upper quadrant pain for past few weeks along with the burning micturition presented to me hospital OPD where his multiple tests were advised by the physician, which includes imaging techniques, biopsies, blood samples, etc. Which among the following is the most practical method for diagnosis of schistosomiasis? Option A, blood test. Option B, urine examination. Option C, fast ELISA. And option D, urine examination. Ultrasound abdomen.
C.
C.
Option B is the right one. Urine examination or stool examination for eggs is the most practical method. However, fast ELISA can be said is the most accurate. This is the key. And thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Isma. Very nice presentation. Very wonderfully you have encompassed all the important aspects of schistosomiasis. Would you please like to shed light that what are the areas in Pakistan where schistosomiasis is causing disease burden, and what are the complications that are being reported from those areas?
Madam, in Pakistan, this is common in areas where people get infected with the fresh water is commonly, like the areas where there are multiple canals or rivers where they swim. And complications are hepatosplenomegaly, where, because it is not immediately diagnosed. And if skin rashes happen, people mostly go to the clinical OPDs for anti-allergics, and so the disease goes undiagnosed. And this leads to chronic features that are all these hepatosplenomegaly, pain abdomen, bladder gets infected, that leads to bone micturition, and urine gets stools and blood stained. All these are the complications of the disease.
I have heard your presentation with great interest, but a few things are deficient. You have to put the map of the areas where schistosomiasis is common in Pakistan, and you have to put a slide on it. The second important thing is that we know schistosomiasis is causing hepatosplenomegaly. It is also causing the lot of destruction of RBCs and later on anemia. We also know that it is causing urinary tract carcinomas. So it is one of a very important cause of different cancers that are affecting urogenital tract. So I would like you to please have another slide about the complications of schistosomiasis that are being reported from different areas in Pakistan. Thank you very much. Otherwise, it is a very good presentation. Allah Hafiz.
Thank you, ma'am.